Hello everyone, welcome back to another vlog. It's been such a mad morning, car's a mess. It's the most amazing day today. It's so sunny and so beautiful. It's my first day like going out. I feel so like so amazing, like so appreciative that it's my first semi-normal day. Same goes for everyone in England anyway, because I know that, you know, places like Canada, France are still in lockdown. So plans are, I have just had my second vaccine. I don't want to talk about it too much because I don't want it to upset people. I know it's controversial, but I have had both of mine. Felt great, fine the first time. Hopefully feel good this time. Hair in a pony. This has been a mad morning. Got my lovely beautiful centre on jacket on that I love, t-shirt that I showed you in the last vlog, gold Kelly. I'm going to Harrods. I'm going to take you with me. We're going to see what it's like now that Harrods has opened up. I did all my nails last night and I've got so much like anxiety driving to my vaccine. I picked it all off. So yeah, I have an appointment at Chanel. I have a few things on hold. I want to get a diary. I want to go in Van Cleef because I'm trying to find something online that's not been in line or online all year. And then I have a meeting outside, so yeah, I'm really excited. Bit of shopping, bit of a meeting. Honoré is with Paris, so it's half two, so he's got him for the afternoon now. We did a swapsie. Yeah, so let's go to Harrods. Going on my hair, I doubled up my mask, just to try and look a little bit more less hospital-like. So it's very empty, but it's a Friday. There's a little queue outside Chanel, but I've got an appointment. Literally can't breathe in this thing. I'm meeting Sabrina, so I'm just gonna go find her. I'll meet you outside, away from the crowd. Just you and me. Excuse me.
Oh, hi.
Sorry. This is a problem when we're together. She's either on her phone doing an email.
Well, not for actual.
Yeah, and then she puts the phone down and then I'm on the phone doing an email. It's fine. We're just hanging out and not speaking. We're both on our phones. So I got my Chanel bits. Where are you going? Sabrina was after a bag. They didn't have it. Wanted one of the neon bags. Now I'm gonna have a look at Jimmy Choo. A couple of pairs of shoes I want, and then I went to Louis Vuitton. Is this? No, one more. Went to Louis Vuitton, which I know is not like me. I wanted one of the diaries, but that sold out. You like my trousers?
Yeah.
Oh, thanks. Yeah, now I'm gonna go to Jimmy Choo and then we're gonna go for lunch. So we've just ended up having lunch. We went to Pavilion Road. This is what happens when you're always out of a CEO. She's always on the phone. We went stationery shopping. We was laughing. We were like, this is what we enjoy doing now. And I'm convincing Sabrina for us to go to Van Cleef and buy friendship bracelets. And she's laughing, saying, Claire, that's not normal. But basically, I just want a new bracelet. She's always buying them, so might as well just get friendship bracelets. I'm actually really cold because I've been outside all day. That was so nice. I try not to worry about the whole COVID thing, otherwise I'll just end up ruining the whole... Oh, look how lovely London looks. But it's the first week out of lockdown.
Yeah.
I'm just going to pop back to Harrods now. So nice to not have a mask on. I got changed. I had this in the car, this Prada one, because it's quite chilly. I'm just waiting for Paris. I've actually seen, sorry, I keep chopping my head off. Right, I'm getting into Tiswas. I've actually been with Paris. We went to like an outside place with his friend and all their babies. I'm just waiting for him now. But I'm actually quite cold. My battery's going, so we're going to catch up tomorrow and I'll show you what I do in Chanel. Hello everyone, so I'm back home. It's actually the next day afterwards. Today is amazing. It's the most beautiful weather, like really hot. I'm talking English hot, but not stuffy, so it's absolutely amazing. I'm feeling so overwhelmed though with the house because it got to the point where it got so bad, everything's a mess. Even this room, like I come in here because it's the most done room, but even this is not done. Like I'm having it all repainted. I've ordered, you know, I told you I was ordering some marble. I actually found something else so incredible. I'm going to tell you what it is now because it's really annoying when I'm like, I'll tell you later. So I actually bought, it's a form of marble, but it's onyx. And I found out after I paid for it, which is fine, the onyx is the most porous, so it's even more fragile than marble. But on here there's going to be no, you know, I don't like, you know, it's going to be fine in here, but with onyx you can light it up, so it's going to look phenomenal. And then I went all out and got all for the dressing table and all of this I'm painting, so yeah, even here it's not done. But anyway, it's a really nice day. We were going to go to a farm with Honoré. I was a bit worried because it was a Sunday, so I think we'll save that for the week. I did a little makeup tutorial on Instagram. Let me know how you feel about me doing more beauty. I've done more beauty here. I'm doing like a beauty series on iTunes V on Instagram because I was always requested to do more beauty. So do let me know if you're enjoying that. It was very weird doing like an Instagram thingamajigawoo. Right, should I show you what I bought in Chanel? I did not, should I pop you up there? It's not the best lighting. I did not vlog as much as what I intended, but the thing is, one, I'm in a rush because of Honoré. I've still not got used to not feeling guilty when I'm not with him, and when I'm vlogging, it actually takes longer doing everything because I stop, although, you know, it's no big deal. It does make my day longer and I really want to rush home to him, and I've not quite, plus when I'm with him, I don't want to vlog too much because I'm all on him. So yeah, sorry I didn't vlog that much. I was quite in and out. I don't want to talk about the vaccine because, you know, I'm so scared I'm going to upset people or push on my opinion. Sorry, that's annoying you. First time round, not ill whatsoever. If anything, I just got myself worked up because everybody's IgM DMing me saying I was going to die. That freaked me out. I was fine. Yesterday I did feel a bit ill, but like a cold, like I had a bit of a cold, my body was aching. Today, fine, like a bit fuzzy headed, but absolutely fine. And I didn't film what I went shopping for Paris's birthday, and he edits the vlogs and I really don't want him to know. So I actually spent a lot of time in like the menswear and everything, and I didn't want to vlog that. And I also, it just feels a bit irresponsible for me because there's still a pandemic and I just felt like going along with my camera, it didn't feel right. So what I can tell you was it felt very safe. When I went to Chanel, there were like three people queuing. I had an appointment, so if you can book an appointment, I do advise that because that was really handy. It did feel really, really safe, and it mentally it felt really nice to get out. It's Sunday today and my friends that are around Harrods said it's a bit of a nightmare. It's really packed. There's a bit of commotion going on outside, so just annoys me that people have to, like, yes, we're introducing going out for everyone's mental health and work and businesses surviving, and then people have to go and take advantage and meet in big groups of like 20 or huge Facebook groups meeting outside Harrods and all these other places. Like, people, it does annoy me that people aren't, like, it's not all back to normal. It's just opening up for the sake of everyone's well-being and work. So yeah, that annoys me. And the littering, come on, going to a park and littering, this is outrageous. Anyway, should we see what I bought in Chanel? You know, I was thinking as well, what is that? What's my product like? I'm so thankful for my new, I'm just in a jogging suit, it's Sunday. Who am I kidding? I'm in a jogging suit every day. I was saying on Instagram today how I've been out 3-4 times and I've worn a tracksuit every single time, and I wore jeans once and I was like, yeah, go back to the tracksuit. So I can officially confirm that I'm still well into the tracksuit. But, you know, a bit more updated, the earrings, the makeup, the hair's not in a bun. So yeah, I'm really enjoying the tracksuit still. And I'm very grateful for my SA, you know, because before I met her, for those of you that get treated badly in Chanel, I hear you. For me, I love Chanel. I love Chanel as a brand, the design team, the creative directors. I love so much about the brand. It's so me, like all the products, I fall in love with something every season. I spend thousands every season. So I don't not like the brand, but there's just something about the service with Chanel. But with that said, I have some of my favourite essays at Chanel, so I can't pull them down. I've actually had some amazing ones over the years, like the odd one that go above and beyond and just very nice and friendly. So I don't know what to even say about that, but I did have a couple of bad experiences that I even didn't really buy that much. And then when I met the person that I shop with now, I'm so thankful for her, because she's just friendly. She's nice. And it's been really good in COVID, because I can just text her saying, I want this, do you have this? So, the first item is another sold out piece. I have these on that I've just not stopped wearing. Three women complimented me on these when I was in Harrods, and like, you could only see that much because the mask. But here they are. Do you know what? I haven't even tried them on. I've sanitized them. Let's try them on. But how cute are they? And they were a lot smaller in real life. See that? Which I really, really liked. I liked it that they were smaller. And they were just so cute, like a little classic flap with the pearl. But I just know, I do have a soft spot for the collectible-like pieces and the really unusual pieces. I do have a soft spot for that. So half the reason why I purchased these was the whole rarity and collector's piece. With that said, I'm not drawn to all the collector's pieces, like the Perspect bags, you know, there's a within reason. I put that in the right way. I was going to say that I think these would have been better in gold, but actually they're champagne gold, which is even nicer. I'm far too close. These couldn't have been any bigger because they're heavy. Let's have a look. I think I'd wear these with my hair up so that you could really see them. Oh, they're cute. I really like them. Yeah, I really like them. They're not as much as I find the other ones I can really wear with literally anything. And of course you can wear these with anything as well. But yeah, they're really, really nice. So, got them. I think they were expensive though. I think they were, because remember if you watched my other vlog, I said that these were £5.60, which is very good price. I think these were more. Let me tell you. I'll tell you exactly how much they were. £6.30. So I guess it makes sense, because there's a little bit more work that goes into them than the other CC. So that does make sense. But I would wear the other ones way, way more. So they were a better buy, and cost per wear these were better, and they're so light to wear. But I do love them. Now, I went in for two other things, and I was going to buy two of them, and my friend bought one or ordered one, and she was like, yeah, and the price is £300. I was like, oh great, yeah, that's great, I'll get both colours. And then they only had this colour, which was my favourite, and I was really surprised with the price, and I think they're a bit expensive, especially because I ruin all my glasses. And the reason why they're so expensive is the rhinestones at the side, but they would have been so much nicer with just white. There was really no need for the rhinestone. One, I can't see them, and two, it just would have been way nicer, way, way nicer, and the price would have been £300. So I couldn't resist these, because They're so 90s. I love a big frame. I absolutely love them. It's not my perfect frame shape, but I love them. I need to get a new mirror. This mirror that I have on my dressing table is not, was meant to be for going on, and I've still got it. And I always say, do not buy things in your home for to be going on. I did that with that mirror, and I really went against my own advice. Do not ever buy anything for going on in your house, because you waste money. Because that mirror was like 200, you know, I'd spend a lot more. It was something I loved, and I begrudge buying a new one, because then I've wasted £200. I don't know what to do with that. And then you're like, oh, that would do. And before you know it, you've had it for 5 years and you're redecorating the whole room. And I did that with the blinds. I was like, oh, just get white blinds to be going on. And I wanted more of a texture. It's been 5 years and I still have these plain white blinds. So yeah, don't buy things to be going on. Anyway, these, they're not my dream frame, but they're nice. Love the 90s. They were £475, which I think is a bit overpriced for sunglasses, says her after she bought them. It was more appealing to have the white ones for £300, and the white ones don't have the rhinestone. So I said, if you do have white ones, let me know, I'll get them. But I'm not overly bothered, but you know, it's a good price. I actually don't buy a lot of expensive sunglasses, just because I'm not a sunglasses person. I always feel really rude speaking to anyone when I have sunglasses on. I will never speak to someone with my sunglasses on, never. Me and Paris both feel the same. We just, if I'm driving, I feel like I can't see properly, and I literally feel like I'm the only one. Me and Paris are the only one, because everyone else I know wears sunglasses driving. They can't go without their sunglasses. Yeah, but I feel like I can't see with them on, and I'm never like a sunglasses person. So I wish I was, but now I'm very tired all the time and got my wrinkles. I need to start getting used to it. So that's why I treated myself to a new pair. So I've got quite a boring week this week. I've got so much work to catch up on. There's so much work coming in. I am going to continue vlogging, otherwise this is going to be quite a boring video, but don't expect anything too dramatic. I'm probably feeding the baby, cleaning and working. With that said, I might save the rest of this vlog for when we go to the farm with Honoré. So it's Sunday. We're going to pop out to get a coffee. I hope you like the little Chanel unboxing. Do you know, I would really love it if you would comment below what you would like to see from me. Would you like me to be going around London showing you places? Would you like more? And don't just say, oh, a bit of everything, because I want to prioritise what you really like. So please maybe just tell me one or two things. Home vlogging, home refurbishment, the brand, styling, my hauls. Maybe give me your top two of what you enjoy, because you were helpful before saying a bit of everything. But then I was like, doing a bit of everything, and I don't think I'm giving you what you want. So I really would appreciate it if you give me like the two things you enjoy: styling, hauls and home. Home refurbishments and vlogging around London, obviously within reason, because I don't actually like going out that much, because I don't think it's that safe. So yeah, I would love it if you'd let me know, and we'll catch up in the week. Hi everyone, I don't know if this is the start of a vlog or the end of a vlog, because I've been vlogging a lot and I'm going to split it into two things. But we've taken, it's actually Paris's birthday today, so we've had the afternoon off-ish. Taken Honoré to the farm. Mum's with us. There's so many kids here, because I guess they're like on school trips and stuff. It's such a nice sunny day. We've actually got this new pram. Ollie's got his hairbrush. He would not let go of the last 2 days. This is the new pram. It's the Cybex Prium, I think it's called. Yeah, Prium. And it's all rose gold. It's really nice. Do you know whose birthday it is today?
No.
Here we go. Ollie! Look at that little baby goats. Hello, little baby goats. Oh, he's answering to go.
Yes, that's a good one. Hey.
Running in circles. Hello, piggy. Oh, it's got lovely feathers. Look at this one, with lovely feathers.
Yeah, I've got cookie for you.
Oh, babies. Good boy, Onnie! So we have been to the farm. Onnie's just had his dinner. He chose this rabbit. Didn't you, Onnie boy? He's been having that, holding that all day. And then we were sitting here. And Onnie was looking over here and we saw little baby chicks. It was so cute. What else happened? So this is one of the bars, no, it's a pub, not a bar, that when you first came here, you're going to regret eating that now on the camera.
Why?
You will. When Paris first came to Essex, I think this is really sunny. Yeah, that's better. No, probably isn't better at all. This was the first place I took him to. You just got the train here, didn't you?
Yeah.
And it's called?
It's called? The shoot.
No, it's not. So yeah, we're having our pub dinner. And his bottle's ready. How's your birthday been? Good?
Have that.
Okay.
Thank you.
Happy birthday to you.
Yay. Make a wish.
Thank you.
Hello, it's my birthday.
Make a wish. Make a wish.
Oh, I forgot I had this on. I can't bear it. Oh, so I'm going to end this vlog here with a little catch up. First of all, I cannot believe that I finally get the sunglasses game. I'm loving these sunglasses, the bigger the better. So obviously I've always liked sunglasses, but I've always just found them a bit annoying. I've never loved them so much because I'm so tired. I just feel like I look so rough all of the time. Plus I'm ill, not COVID, just a cold. I had to pop out. Well, not pop out. I have a meeting really early this morning. And it's my friend that I'm meeting, which I'll tell you about in a second. But even with her, I just can't face it like this. And I need to pick up coffee. So yeah, loving sunglasses. I've literally just thrown something on. So, by the way, loving this bag. I cannot believe how much I'm using it. It is so practical. Another thing about sunglasses is I never have a bag big enough, and this is the biggest cover. It fits that. It fits my vlogging camera, hand sanitizer, phone. It literally fits everything. It's so amazing. I'll link it below. Such a fab bag. I'm really happy with it. And it also matches my baby bag, which you would have seen yesterday. Yeah, the farm was amazing. So today, I'm going to talk to you a quick second about Ruslan. So if you follow me on Instagram, you will know that I put out something the other day. Just so many people are asking me, I'm going to have my coffee with you. So many, actually it's Nero. How do Nero get their coffees so hot? I mean, I love it, but they're just piping hot. It's like lava. What's too hot? What was I saying? Yep, so you've all been asking me, when is Runestone happening? And this is not the plan for Runestone. I wanted to get it out. I mean, we won't get into the details of when it was, when I was meant to do this, but it was meant to be like February. But, and I wanted to announce it and then get it banged out after 2 months, and then it just, you know, forever was bosh, bosh, bosh. But we've had so many delays and just random stuff happening. One of my factories, who I was so happy to have it, because I realized after I'd signed everything that it was actually one of the best, one of my favorite brands factory, and they've closed down. And they were quite sneaky about it, like never, I had to like figure it out for myself, so that was stressful. One of the countries that I'm working with, they're really suffering with COVID. And there's so many delays, and I felt bad for them telling me, because I could hear in her voice she felt bad and was worried to tell me. But then I felt worried to tell you because it's another delay. So it's just, and you know, I'm spending so long with the fit. Like, I got a sample last night. I was so happy with it. I was starting to feel really worried about everything. One, I think I've gone too niche, because although I think the foundation of this one look is amazing, I have put something in it that makes it a bit niche, so I know it's going to exclude a lot of people, not fit wise, design wise. But then it came last night and I loved it. So I just thought, if I love it, then at least one other person has got to love this. So that is really positive news. And sorry, I'm jumping from thing to thing. I just don't want to be late for this meeting. So that's the update basically. And it is coming. It was meant to be an April launch, then it got pushed to May. And I think realistically it's going to be the end of June. It's not ideal, especially for the main part of what I'm launching. It's like February, April spring attire. It's not height of summer attire, but nothing I can do about it. So I've been doing all of this on my own, obviously with Paris, who's always supported me, dragged him around trade shows, fabric shows. He's done all of like the finance foundation behind the brand, so of course he helps me. But design, everything I've done on my own, the measurements, the designing, the factory finding, the fabric finding, literally everything on my own. And it's been a lot. It's just been so much. And then to get the fit perfect, that is when I thought, Claire, you can't do everything. And as a business owner and, you know, a manager that's running a company, the rule number one is that you find people to execute things that you can't do. So I'm not the best design technician. I know that. I'm not good at pattern cutting. I did it at university, but it's not my strong point. Sorry, I'm talking to you with my glasses. I feel rude. It's not my strong point, and when it comes to measurements and CAD drawings, that's not my strong point. And I was considering teaching myself, and I just thought, of all of these delays, I just need to get a design technician. So one of my best friends in the world is a designer, but she's also a design technician, so she's very skilled at measurements, CAD drawings, and it's essential to have CAD drawings and intricate details so that you don't get any delays. So I've been working with her on maybe in like the last couple of months, and I've got the final sample next to me for one of the items. I should have even put some lipstick on. I'm so happy with it. I can't wait to show you, but it needs a few fit tweaks because I want it to be perfect. So I'm having a meeting with her now, which I really need to get going, and we're gonna have coffee. But I cannot wait for you to see it. Just thank you for your patience. That's all I wanted to say, really, is taking me 5 minutes. But thank you so much for your patience. Tomorrow, I'm having a lot of work done on my face. There you go, I said it. I just really feel like I want it. So I was going to put it in this vlog, but it's too long. So make sure you're subscribed. I will share a little bit on Instagram, I think. So follow me on stories and follow me on Instagram. But I am going to be doing a whole vlog of what I'm having done to my face. And I think I'll put in there about my teeth as well, because a lot of you have been asking what I did with that. So thank you for watching. I would love it if you would subscribe. I'd love it if you would follow me, Claire Chanel, on Instagram. I'd love it if you would also give a follow along to Rue Sloan, because I think in the next couple of weeks I'm going to be sharing things on there. So thanks for watching, and I'll catch you in my next vlog.